Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Zeke, and this is Dogumentary TV, and this is a new episode of The List. In this list, we will be breaking down the Dogumentary TV audience's top 10 catch dogs. All right, before we get into the video, please, if you haven't already, subscribe to the channel. And while you're watching this video, at some point, please hit the like button. For those of you who are unfamiliar with the catch dog, a catch dog is a dog that is used to hold large animals. This could be out on a hunt, as in wild boar or bear, or it actually could be on a farm or ranch holding cattle. All right, now you guys are giving me a very interesting list. I'm going to break down your list, and I'm going to give you guys my feedback. So this is kind of like flipping the script. Typically, I create a list, and you guys criticize it. Well, I'm going to flip the script. You guys created this list, and I'm going to give you guys my critiques. All right, let's jump into it. At number 10, you guys have the Alano Espanol. This is a Spanish bulldog, very solid pick. My only critique would probably be that I would maybe have this a little bit higher, probably like in the middle of my pack of top catch dogs. But this is a solid pick, and I'm very impressed that you guys know enough to think highly of this breed. Number 9 on you guys' list, you guys have the Alapaha Blue Blood Bulldog. Another solid pick. It really shows me that the Dogumentary TV audience, you guys are really educated, very well informed, and you guys know your dog breeds. This is a somewhat of a rare bulldog breed. Comes from the south of the United States, but a very good and very capable catch animal. At number 8, you guys have the Bull Terrier. Again, another solid pick. I have no problems with this one at number 8. I guess I do have a problem with it. I would probably have it, looking at the rest of the dogs on your list, I would maybe have it maybe definitely at least one or two spots higher. But, you know, hey, you guys got it at number 8, a solid pick. At number 7, you guys chose the Band Dog. I like Band Dogs. I think that there's a lot of quality control issues when it comes to Band Dogs. So therefore, I'm assuming that you guys have a solid source to get a Band Dog that's really geared towards catching prey or catching large game, and not a Band Dog that's going to be used, say, for home protection or property protection or other specialized jobs. At number 6, you guys have the Staffordshire Bull Terrier. This is what I call a homer pick. Obviously, we have a lot of Staffordshire Terrier fans in my audience, and while I love the Staffy Bull, I think they are great. I don't think they, because of their size specifically, they're not going to make a great catch animal. I don't know what you're catching. Maybe you catch raccoon. I don't think these dogs are equipped to handle a large game, but you guys picked them, so they're on the list. At number 5, you guys have the American Bulldog. Another great pick. For me, American Bulldog is a top 3 catch animal. Now, with the American Bulldog, there's a lot of variety, because you have the Scott, the Johnson, and you have the hybrid, which is a combination of both the Scott and the Johnson. And then there's a lot of other things, what I would call specialty bulldogs, meaning that the American Bulldogs are really bred regionally and really bred for a specific game. And that's a good thing and a bad thing in terms of catch animal, because obviously you need to find a dog that is bred for the thing that you're trying to catch. But I love the American Bulldog. Like I said, for me, it would be a top 3 pick at the very least, or possibly a top 2 pick. At number 4, you guys have the Cane Corso. Obviously, again, I would say this is probably another homer pick. Homer pick meaning that there are a lot of Cane Corso fans in my audience. So therefore, there are a lot of votes for the Cane Corso as a catch dog. Now, the traditional Cane Corso coming out of Italy, I think that is a great argument for that version of the Cane Corso to be an elite catch dog. Unfortunately, in the United States, we don't really have a whole lot of those types of Cane Corso. I would probably have the Cane Corso in the top 10, but I wouldn't have it up this high specifically because, like I said, most of the Cane Corso that are being bred around the world, and specifically in the United States, are not really working catch dogs, aren't being bred to be catch animals. At number three, you guys have the Preset Canario. I love this pick. At number three, maybe this would be my fourth breed, looking at the other two on the list. But I do love the Preset Canario. I think the Preset Canario is an amazing working dog. And because of the way it's being bred, still being bred in the United States, I do come across a lot of people who have working presses, and they're doing good work in Texas and California on hogs and other large game. So I think the Preset Canario is perfect at number three. Although if it was on my list, it might be number four. All right, so and then at number two, you guys have the American Pit Bull Terrier. I'm gonna say this is a homer pick, meaning that there's a lot of American Pit Bull Terrier fans in my audience, and therefore the breed is ranked very high. I will, however, say this, that I do believe that the breed is very much deserving of its place in the list. Now, at number two, it's a tad high for me. I think I would have it around three or four myself. I'm going to give you guys my top four, I think, when I'm done, because I think it's kind of important. I think it'll be relevant since I keep referencing, you know, where I want these things to be at. I'll give you guys my top four after I do yours. So, yeah, I love the American Pit Bull Terrier, obviously a very universally recognized breed. We know how hard it works. We know how hard the prey drive in the breed. American Pit Bull Terrier for sure. And then number one on your list, the Dogo Argentino. Probably the most complete catch dog. I mean, I love the size, the tenacity, balance of this breed. It deserves to be number one, and most likely is number one on my list. Now, let me quickly go into my top four, just because I want to give a point of reference. I know there was a lot of criticism, and I do see a lot of people rooting for or voting for their favorite breed, and not necessarily taking the topic seriously. Like, they're like, you know, Staffy Bull honestly shouldn't be on the list. Not in the top 10. I'm not saying that it's not a catch animal. I'm not saying that there aren't things that it can catch, but it shouldn't be in the top 10. So let me give you my top four, and this is just roughly in my head. I'm going to go at number four. I'll probably go with the American Pit Bull Terrier. Number three, the Presser. Number two, American Bulldog. And then number one, the Dogo. I believe that's right. I'm not seeing all the breeds that are out there in my head. But in terms of catch dogs, I think those are universally used as catch dogs and probably are the most effective for that purpose. All right, guys, there you go. I appreciate you guys participating. I'm just going to ask in the future that we think more about the actual subject so that the list is a little bit more useful to other people and that we're not just picking our favorite dog breeds. But beyond that, you know, I appreciate the Dogumentary TV community. We're going to keep doing more lists because I enjoy them and I think you guys get some value out of them as well. All right, guys, this is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV.